You see his attitude change. When he talks football, he's older than so. You know, they jump up in the world. You can see the growth. It's really exciting to be a football fan. Now living in the Bay Area, you can see how much the Raiders mean to the city of Oakland. So it's fun. It's fun seeing them. It's fun having two teams that are playing pretty well.
Have y'all gotten to know each other?
A couple of Raiders guys. I know a few. You know, just being in the same in LA. Like I said, it's always good to have two teams in the same city playing well, and that just brings another level of energy to the city of Oakland, so it's a good thing.
In any comparison you saw between Raiders fans?
Football game is a different atmosphere, obviously, but they get pretty loud and pretty rowdy in there. When I was leaving the Raider game, that's when it was the best. I was so excited after a win. You could just see it in everybody's eyes. It's a new season, it's a new change. They're trying to grab something special with this Super Bowl. So we'll see how it goes.
Are they growing?
No, I'm the worst.
Die hard.
I like the team. Love the team. Yeah, I believe that bird game goes.
You compared to me. I know you started playing against certain guys. Paul, what have you seen from Paul? He's been kind of in and out a little bit, but he's back in the clutch now.
He's my favorite player in the league. I've been saying that for a while. He's so smooth, man. Can do it all. Fast, can rebound, defend, shoot the game, post up, have the ball. He's my favorite player. You know, just getting to know him over the last few years, it makes for competition. It makes the competition even better when we play against each other. So I got nothing but respect for Paul, and it's a mutual respect. We always have battles when we play against each other, so I'm looking forward to it.
He's been
really quiet. It's like, you can feel the energy. You feel that we both want to win at a high level and we want to play well. But after the game, we just all love. And I think that's the type of competition that you're starting to see more of. The last 10 years since I've been in the league, is that guys have become friends off the court from USA Basketball to dating all the way back to an AAU ball, college ball, and then, when you're on the court, you act like you're one of those guys. And then after the game's over, it's all love. So it brings a different level of competition to the game of basketball.
Why do you think there's in the league over the past decade?
AAU basketball plays a big part. You're seeing these guys since you were 8 or 9 years old. That's deeper than going out on the NBA court and supposed to hate each other. But you've been knowing these guys for 10, 15 years, and the league is getting younger and younger. So you play against these guys 1 year in high school ball, and then you go to college, and then you're playing against them in the league 2 years later. So just knowing these guys, playing against them, and being around them all summer for USA Basketball, that's helped a lot too. That's grown the game. Having all the best players in one area competing against each other and playing on the same team. Adds another level of value to your friendship. I can see you watch Kyrie Irving and Kyle Lowry, they go at it, but they're the best of friends. They built that bond throughout the summer of being a Team USA. So I think that's what we all have. It's not a bad thing. I don't think it's a bad thing at all. We still compete at a high level.
What
the same things on basketball court. He's low maintenance. He's a superstar, but he's a low maintenance guy. Doesn't need much. Same type of attitude that I bring. Loves to play the game, loves to work too. So we kind of click.
So you guys spend time.
We all spend time together. The whole team. We're really, really tight. Small Paul and him, man, he injured his leg that summer. We played Team USA as well, so we practiced together, played one-on-one together, beat him hard, played one-on-one together throughout that summer, so we kind of built the bond there. So it's fun playing against him. It's going to be a great, great competition. It's going to be fun. This team is different from the team we played last game, so it should be a good matchup.
What did you think of him getting on the big-time crew?
He wasn't. Memphis, maybe second or third year in the league. They went to the playoffs and started to recognize what he does. He was a defender first. You see a lot of those type of guys that come in under the radar, no expectations, just work their tails off. You see him, Jimmy Butler, Isaiah Thomas is in the league. You see so many guys that start off with no expectations under the radar and just bust on the scene. That's, you know, I respect guys like that. You know, they keep working, they'll never get down on themselves, and you can call him one of those guys. So I respect his game, his work ethic, and his competitive fire. I don't say you learn anything that you didn't know. It's more so just trying to get better. It's not different than playing against a young man. You know what they bring. You know what type of player they are. So I wouldn't say I figured out anything new that I didn't know about PG one game. It was just the fact that we wanted to have a little competition. We wanted to play one-on-one. That's the only way to get better on individual skills, I think. One of the only ways. We use it to our advantage.